Now at 11, by air, by foot, a massive manhunt drags into the night.
He has shown that he is going to use violence.
The deadly countywide crime spree.
There's some gunshots, like five or six, like pop, 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 pop.
Causing hours of chaos.
Developing tonight, the search for Gregory Moore. I'm Rick Fulbaugh.
And I'm Erica Sargent. He's believed to be heavily armed and was last seen on foot after three carjackings across Broward County and one deadly shooting. We have live team coverage tonight. We start with CBS 4's Carrie Codd in Fort Lauderdale.
Carrie.
Erica, the last time anyone saw Gregory Moore was around 9 o'clock this morning. He was running away from an accident scene not too far from here at the Fort Lauderdale Police Department, a few blocks west of here, Broward Boulevard and I-95. He somehow eluded a massive police manhunt, and tonight, the feds say they need the public's help to catch him. The FBI says Gregory Moore is behind a violent Tuesday morning crime spree that left a man dead, a woman critically injured, and several drivers in fear for their lives. And Moore remains on the loose.
He is armed and dangerous. He has shown that he is going to use violence.
Moore's campaign of terror began on Sunrise Boulevard, police say, when he carjacked a woman at gunpoint, taking her child to school on Tuesday. Then came another carjacking on 95. Then Moore is accused of opening fire on this car in Hallandale Beach, killing a man inside and seriously injuring a woman. The FBI says Moore tried and failed to carjack two more vehicles before succeeding in crashing that stolen car near Broward Boulevard and I-95. After that, Moore ran off. What was his motivation for the crimes? Investigators say they don't know, but they do believe Moore is desperate.
There's no question he's desperate in the sense that he is running from shooting two individuals, killing one of them, and using a gun on several individuals on 95 in the middle of traffic.
Cops, deputies, and canines searched high and low for Moore but could not locate him. The search snarled traffic and left five schools on lockdown. New information emerged late Tuesday that less than 72 hours before Moore allegedly wreaked havoc, Moore was in handcuffs on a gun charge in Lauderhill early Sunday morning. Police there are also calling him a person of interest in a shooting in their city. We're told two potential victims, though, did not cooperate with police. Lieutenant Greg Solowski said after his arrest, Moore was given a bond and walked out of jail.
This is the bond process and the legal system that the officers are sworn to uphold.
We checked Moore's criminal history. It shows he's been in and out of prison five times since 1997 on drug, robbery, and weapons charges. He last left prison in February of this year. The FBI wants to send him back for his actions on Tuesday, and investigators say they need tips from the public to do it.
I can't stress enough how dangerous this person is.
As one law enforcement official told me today, if Broward County had a top 10 most wanted, Gregory Moore would be at the top of the list tonight. The FBI says they want to arrest Moore on federal carjacking charges. They say if anyone knows where he is, call 911 immediately. Live in Fort Lauderdale, Carrie Codd, CBS 4 News Tonight.
Carrie.